The American composer John Cage and a Korean music student named Nam June Paik met in a small town in Germany in the late 50s. A close, sometimes violent friendship developed for almost 20 years. They discovered a deep mutual concern that a modern cybernated society might turn mankind into a parade of mindless robots. Mr. Cage was then composing music for audience participation, what might be called music for the people, of the people, by the people. Mr. Paik later helped create participatory television, in which viewers are no longer robots, but human beings, who can talk back and strike back at their TV sets. The next segment is created by two passers-by who dropped into a video commune and did their own thing. We don't know their names. Dao is nameless.
Associate Professor of Music at Wesleyan University. And I'd like to ask him, who is John Cage?
It's actually, as Barbara Rose of the New York magazine wrote in American Art since 1900. Actually, she wrote the book in 1968. To trace the genealogy of pop art, one must recreate the atmosphere in which it came into being. That atmosphere was generated mainly by the composer John Cage, whose essays and lectures have been instrumental in forming the sensibility of some of the most important young composers, choreographers, painters, and sculptors at work today.
Heard that John Cage, in his way, made Woodstock famous in music history long before the Rock Festival, or even Bob Dylan.
Well, actually, you know, you're perfectly right. You know, as you look back on the events of the past, one must put things in their proper perspective. And it was actually August 29th, 1952, the David Tudor, the famous pianist who now, of course, has become a famous composer in his own right, performed the piano piece 4 minutes and 33 seconds in the Averick Auditorium up in the town of Woodstock. And that being a very historic moment and of course carrying much more artistic and historic eight, we should really, to be perfectly frank, regard that as the first authentic Woodstock, and that the Woodstock that just occurred with the, you know, 500,000 human beings sitting in the mud under the hot sun for all those days really isn't as important as that historic piano performance.
Performance at Woodstock in the summer of 1952. 4 minutes and 33 seconds of complete silence. For our international viewers, Harvard Square is the Times Square of American brain. Surrounded by Harvard Yard, Brigham's Ice Cream Parlor, Hungry Charlie's Hamburgers, we're standing at the famous newspaper stand, which was burned down during the violent days of student revolution. Here, on this hallowed ground, a line of distinguished eggheads from Henry James to Henry Kissinger learned to think the unthinkable. Let's see how John Cage plays an unplayable music, accepting all noises as beautiful music. The name of the game tonight is how to enjoy boredom, a privilege usually reserved only for aristocrats. Let's chant Om together, or turn on a vacuum cleaner and enjoy the buzz. This is what the Chinese Oracle I Ching told us to do tonight. Here's Johnny and the hit parade of the year 2001.